Thank you so much for joining us, John and KK, and many congratulations on such a fabulous announcement coming from the Coca-Cola India stable. For the uninitiated, Coca-Cola has just announced that they are going to be taking their very, very popular brand in India, Thums Up Global. So many congratulations. KK, I'll start with you to talk about, you know, how this trigger came about, because for the longest time, whether it's true or not, we have been under the impression that Coca-Cola has been trying hard to get its global brand, Coke, to the number one position, and, you know, has all attempts have been made to somewhat thwart the homegrown brands which were acquired many years ago. So there seems to be a sudden change in mindset, you know, in the way you're approaching all your brands. So what's the big shift about?
Basically, I think there's a huge difference between perception and reality. From the time we had Thumbs Up with us, we've been doing everything to ensure that we service the Thumbs Up consumer well. And the good news has been that it's done very well in the last many years, and it has established a pretty strong position for itself amongst its consumers. So as we really looked at Thumbs Up and the journey it has traversed in the last 40 years, we did realize that it had a great proposition which could be taken far beyond India. So we felt that it needed a bit of relevance building, and so we created Thumbs Up Charged, and we launched it in India with a reasonable amount of success, and she said it's ready to go now. So that's been the journey. At all points of time, we did feel that Thumbs Up was going to be forever one of our lead brands in India. And now we have, after managing it for some time, got the confidence that it's got teeth beyond the shores of India.
That is truly very heartening. But I'll come to you, John, and really excited to be talking to you, because I read a lot about what you said to your investors in Atlanta recently. And it's very heartening to hear what you said, because I think for the first time there has been an admission of sorts that, you know, in a market like India, you know, you all have not done enough to kind of leverage brands that have been quintessentially successful in this market. And, you know, you've also admitted that you've not really cracked the code. So a little bit about that.
Sure. First of all, I think, you know, we've been in business for over 100 years and always endeavor to meet the needs of our consumer base. I think we would be the first to admit that the world has changed, is changing, and we need to sharpen that focus. In a market like India, it's absolutely critical that we really understand the Indian consumer in many, many parts of the country. Like is it a country or a continent? I keep asking myself.
Sure.
And so what I think we're doing a better job of is realizing that the Indian consumer has a very, very diverse set of needs. That require a much broader and stronger portfolio of brands to be able to deliver against them. And number one. Number two is, I think there's three Indias, not one India, when it comes to, when you look at the socioeconomic makeup of the country. We do not have a relationship with over 750 million people here. So when I said we didn't crack the code, it's against that backdrop, and I think we have a tremendous opportunity to develop new solutions that take into account what the needs are of not only a regional diverse base, but a very diverse socioeconomic base too. And we're excited to be on that journey now.
Right. Would you agree that there is with the new management, you know, coming in with James on the top, and there's been with you now heading APAC, would you say there is somewhat a change in mindset as well? There's a recognition of what needs to be done, where there are vacuums, as opposed to obsessing with, you know, the global brands.
I would think that we're somewhat more agnostic as to where growth comes from. And we're very much more focused on really understanding our consumer base.
I really ask this question only because while KK, who's been a a long-termer in the Coke system would understand, you know, how popular the Thumbs Up franchise has been in India and
yes.
has been the number one cola now for, you know, eons. The fact that, you know, he would have had to market this pitch to his global counterparts and the fact that it was accepted is also, you know, telling of the change of mindset.
Yeah, no, and I think it's true based on, like, my own experience. I spent a long part of my career in Japan. Japan today has $3 or $4 billion locally developed brands. It set out on a journey in the 90s to aspire to meet the needs of the Japanese consumer on every beverage occasion, which led to the creation of a much different portfolio there. And for many years, it was treated as more of an anomaly, and today it's more of an example. So, I think ears are maybe more open,
mm-hmm.
and recognition that to be a truly global company, you've got to be really local at the same time, and understand what's happening locally.
Well, on that note, I think it's time to take a look at the video, which really, you know, encompasses the entire Thumbs Up journey.
Tufan. ये जब भी उठा करते हैं या हवाओं की जिद को बयां करते हैं आज ये तूफान जो पूरे आसमान पे छाया है जिद्दी हवा का झोंका ये कभी तुमने ही तो उठाया है न देखते तुम ये ख्वाब तो हम ये सैलाब कहां देखते ना उठती लहर साहिल से तो ये समंदर कहां देखते छू रहा है अब नई बुलंदियों को ये तूफान है किसी भी मंजिल पे ठहरता कहां है ये कई मकाम पा लिए कई अभी बाकी है इस देश से उठे तूफान को अभी दुनिया का सलाम बाकी है अब जब निकल पड़ा है ये दुनिया में बनाने अपनी पहचान तुम्हारी तूफानी सोच को इस तूफान का सलाम
So when you talk about taking thumbs up global, you're going to start with, of course, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Nepal, which is almost home for us. Have you done any kind of, test marketing in these countries to kind of give you a sense what the success, ratio will be and if their palates are similar to ours in terms of sparkling drinks?
Well, I want to start by saying while they may be closer to home, they are separate countries.
Yeah, sure.
And we respect the consumers of those countries and their choice. And so we have done some preliminary research in these countries. And it was only on that basis we really did this relevance building, which we launched in India as Thumbs Up Charge.
Right.
So we believe our chances of success are pretty good when we go into these countries. Obviously, there will be a learning because we need to adapt and make it relevant to the local consumers of Bangladesh or Sri Lanka or Nepal, which we would do as we go through our launch process and scale up.
Okay. You also talked about wanting to make Thumbs Up a billion-dollar brand. Give me some sense of the journey towards the billion-dollar mark.
Well, I think it would possibly have two parts to the journey. One is really expansion into other countries, which I think we will start, as I said, in the first quarter. The second part is to really keep looking at places or spaces where Thumbs Up can play, and then trying to create variations. For instance, we definitely have on the anvil a launch of a no sugar variant
in
the Thumbs Up Charge franchise. So. It's going to have these two parts to its journey. One part is to keep expanding Thumbs Up to occupy spaces which are adjacent to the present need of the consumer, mm-hmm. and the other is to geographically expand the footprint. So between these two, we are pretty sure that very soon we would be able to get to that mark.
If I may ask, where does it stand right now?
Actually, we are pretty much progressed internally in terms of how to do it. you will see it in external.
No, I mean in terms of its valuation. Where does it stand right now?
It's not too far away from $1 billion.
It's not. So you envisage it achieving that mark
pretty
end of
soon.
The year?
2 years max.
2 years max.
By the end of next year is the.
It's the target.
Is the ambition.
Okay, and that will be the first $1 billion brand out of India.
That's correct.
Okay, you talked about the fact that APAC is a very important region simply because 52% of the global population resides here.
Yes.
And compared to the West in terms of our consumption patterns, you said, there's a lot of potential simply because this region consumes more non-commercial than commercial, and hence the opportunity is just limitless. John, if you could throw some light on how you're going to convert the non-commercial consumption to commercial consumption, given that, the APAC region has its own cultural behavior.
Yeah. A couple of things. First of all, I think there is a natural evolution. As the middle class continues to grow, and it will grow pretty strongly over the next 10 to 15 years across many of the developing markets. People have more access to money, and when you have more access to money, they tend to have a hierarchy of spending needs, and beverages is in the sweets in the early stages of that. So, I see the consumer base broadening, with more people entering into the middle class, and with more urbanization taking place across. All of Asia Pacific, it allows us to have greater access to a much broader base.
Okay.
So by doing the math, you'll end up with a pretty significant move from the traditional non-commercial to the commercial arena.
Just to give me a sense, if 52% of the population resides in this region,
yes.
How much is it contributing currently to Coca-Cola's revenues overall?
Roughly in the high 20s, roughly.
And you see that obviously going up, as we move forward. So could you give me an estimate of how much you see that grow and by when?
Well, I would expect us to be growing healthy mid-single digit across the region for years to come, and over contributing as part of the global equation.
Right. KK, correct me if I'm wrong, but in the Indian market, I believe that if you just look at the sparkling category, Sprite is number one, followed by Thums Up, of course, which is the number one cola of the country. And for the longest time, we all assumed it was Pepsi and then Coke. Am I correct to assume that the brand Coke has overtaken brand Pepsi?
See, it's difficult to say from Nielsen data because that keeps going up and down. But I believe that Coke has moved up in the hierarchy. That's something I can sort of confidently say.
Because you're so ambiguous, moved up in the hierarchy.
and so it's sort of, I would say it's plus minus. So that's where I would leave it, because we don't have exact data of competition, which is very difficult to acquire. But from Nielsen perspective, it keeps going up and down. That's what I meant.
Okay. I want to talk a little bit about the road in India for the last 3 years or so. It's been a tough and rocky one, and chasing growth has been also very difficult, although India is such a under-penetrated market. If you could throw some light on why it has been so difficult to grow in this market, and how do you envisage chasing growth in the next few years, given that you have such ambitious plans and there is so much of focus in terms of shaking things up? If you could throw some light on that.
See, any company in its journey in a country goes through
ups
certain
and downs.
Changes.
Of course, yes.
I'm not even saying ups and downs. The changes are partly driven by some changes in macroeconomic fundamentals, and also by consumer preferences.
Yeah,
I think
sure.
The last 2-3 years have been a mix of both. While we have had some macroeconomic interventions, etc., but we've also had some changing consumer choices. So any company needs to, every few years of its journey, reset itself to build back relevance. I think we went through that journey in the last couple of years, and I think we are at least fairly well understanding of the present situation in terms of consumer preferences and choices.
Explain that to me, KK.
See, I think consumer has upped the choice in terms of categories they want to drink. Number two, I think the consumer looks for slightly more customized and ethnic beverages.
Is it?
Number three, yes, you can see that, and that's where the smaller players are coming in.
Yeah, sure.
And number three is the fact that we had to expand our connection with the 750 million Indians whom we have really not established a connect. We have still been experimenting, which is what John alluded to. So these are the three resets we are trying to really do today. So how do we really get our portfolio to become more relevant to today's consumers' aspirations and choices and preferences? And number two, how do we connect with an increasing number of incidents? See, our growth is a three-step process. The first step is we recruit more consumers from, say, tap water to our beverages. Number two, once we recruit the consumer to drink once, how do we make them transact more? And number three is, when the consumer is already with you and is transacting more, how do you upsize the consumer? This is a very simple model. But this model is complicated by the fact it's not simple to do all these things. So every few years you need to reset these to be more relevant to the consumer of this generation. And that's the process we went through last 2 years. I think we are well in terms of positioned ourselves well in terms of start of the journey. Obviously there will be learning, and I think we should be in for a good time in terms of getting back to our journey of great growth. And I want to again clarify that it's not that the 2 years have been a huge sort of drop. It's we were growing, we were having a heady growth.
Sure.
We came into slightly lower levels of growth, and we are setting ourselves to get back to good growth. That's the way I would describe it.
Fair enough. Would you like to add to it?
No, I think we also play in an industry where a lot of others see opportunity. And just in my travels around India, it's impressive to see the number of new players that are coming into the industry. I think we have an opportunity to, as KK said, to expand our portfolio to be able to participate in areas where historically we have not been. And I see that as being a big opportunity going forward. And as we've highlighted, there's been some specific areas where we have had a jolt. Demonetization was a challenging period. The whole taxation arena
GST has been
challenging. But you take those punches as they come, and I think we're back on our feet, and we're ready to enjoy a very good period going forward.
John, you mentioned that it is important for the company at large to be very consumer centric, and by that you mean that even look at categories where you are not participating currently, but where consumers seem to show a lot of interest and maybe dive in.
Yes.
Which categories, and any both of you could take this, which categories do you think are showing immense potential, where you're probably currently absent and are looking to move in?
Yeah, let me take the regional lens first, and
sure.
Maybe KK can talk about the more local lens. Regionally, for example, I see tea as being a category that will enjoy tremendous growth.
Tea.
Ready-to-drink tea. I know our business in Japan very well. We currently have $2 billion brands in the tea category,
right,
in Japan. One is called Ayataka, and one is called Sokambicha, the blended tea. When you look at consumer trends around the region, you see that category with tremendous upside potential, and so I would be looking to bet heavily on tea in just about every region. Here in India, tea is still a nascent,
yeah,
ready-to-drink segment.
Ready to drink, yeah.
I see it as an area to explore, and to be ready when the moment is right becoming a very, very big category to rival the sparkling category. So I think you have to look at it market by market, but in general, the newer categories are going to catch up.
Right. KK, I want to talk about the fact that, you know, Thums Up, which, of course, that's the headline news for today's interview, is, you know, you're finally allowing to travel outside India. Let's not forget that Thums Up was, you know, the brainchild of Ramesh Chauhan from, you know, formerly known as Parley, now Bisleri. I believe you reached out to him, you know, to, I guess, get his blessings, yeah, good wishes. Tell me about that experience.
See, even when I moved into this job, I think one of the first persons I met was Mr. Ramesh Chauhan, or in our Indian terms, Chauhanji. So I traveled to Mumbai and sought his blessings, because I said 50% of my portfolio is what you created.
Yeah, sure.
So while I work for Coke, but I still need your blessing. So I really connected with him at that point of time. So when this came in, I made a request to him saying that we're going to do that, and this is going to be a big, big thing for not only the Coca-Cola company in India, but for us as Indians. And you created this brand, and we're going to take in, and in true Indian tradition, I want you to bless it. And so he was very nice and warm and gracious, and he said, of course. And so it was for us a very emotional moment, more as an Indian. And then now I get on to my job as part of the Coca-Cola company to take it forward.
That's true. And we've actually captured that on video, so do take a look.
No soft drink company can afford not to have a cola. They have to have a cola. So on that basis, we started Thums Up. And a lot of people ask, okay, how did you build up the brand? No product is any good if there's somebody not looking after it, no matter how good it is. It's the custodian, somebody who's really emotionally attached to it. But the emotion which you put behind it, and the commitment from all the people, that makes it great. I wish to give the blessings to make sure that you guys continue the commitment and attachment to it. I'm sure it will always remain number one. That's the key.
KK, also give me some insight before I let you go on, you know, some insight on the other franchises that you have that you're also focusing on, whether it be Minute Maid or it be Maaza. What are we going to see from the Coke stable in India in terms of their variations, or, you know, just energizing the brand?
Yeah. Other than sparkling, the two major categories we're going to really work on are really juice and juice-based products, and hydration and enhanced hydration. Mm-hmm. In the area of juice-based products, you're going to see a broader portfolio of Maaza in the market this year.
Okay.
We have Maaza Refresh for people who are on the go and who want to have a refreshing product.
How will that be different from Maaza?
That would be available in what we call as immediate consumption packs only, which is basically a Tetra Pak offering to start with.
Okay.
So that people can buy it, it's easily, and drink easily. And then
it's a smaller SKU?
Yeah, it's a smaller SKU. It will be in the space of 150 ml to 250 ml. And then we have offered the highest level of indulgence you can have on a mango drink called Maaza Gold, which again is available in a larger pack, because we expect it will be more consumed at home.
Sure.
And it will be distributed. So Maaza basically is going to go with a broader franchise. On the Minute Maid franchise, we are going to go forward with whatever we had committed. We're going to expand the franchise to include products made out of fruits, which are by state, by regions, by small clusters. So you can expect a lot of variants which are state-specific coming out of this table. While we'll continue to expand our pulpy range, we have orange, we have Musambi, so we will find other possibilities in terms of expanding it. And we are also looking at coming this year with what we had said. We would launch a beverage plus, We have more or less signed all the key agreements that we need to be. And India will see Minute Maid Perfect Fruit, which is actually a frozen serving of fruit.
Ah.
It has no added dairy, it has no added sugar, but it is all fruit. So we expect that we would launch that in the second quarter of this year India for the summer season.
Is that an India first?
This is after Australia, India.
First, okay.
Okay. So that on the hydration front, we have just now come out with our enhanced hydration product called Smart Water.
Yeah.
It's produced and in India, in Bangalore, and launched now in a few metros. And you will see much more activity in Aquarius, which is the other enhanced hydration product that we have. So this would be broadly the sort of initiatives you will see outside sparkling. And sparkling, obviously, you've seen Thums Up Charge, and you will see Rimzim being launched nationally.
Fair enough. On that note, thank you so much, Chauhan. Thank you, KK.
Thank you.
And all the very best for the journey ahead with Coca-Cola in India and globally. And again, great news coming from the Coke table on Thums Up. Thanks again.